What's up, everyone? On the Gas here, and welcome to the second episode of the Top 5 NASCAR Crashes of the Week, this week at Las Vegas. Sorry for last week, another missed episode, but that was simply because there weren't enough crashes. I think there were really only 3 or 4 throughout the weekend. It was still a great weekend full of action, but unfortunately not enough to make a Top 5 Crashes of the Week. Before we begin, once again, I want to shout out the winners, starting off with John Hunter Nemechek, winning in dominating fashion, beating Kyle Busch in the truck race, AJ Allmendinger, winning in emotional fashion, grabbing his second intermediate win of his career. Just a few minutes ago, the cup race ended, Kyle Busch with another emotional win on his Cup Series return. Congratulations to all those guys. For the second week running, the trucks were a wreck fest and are going to cover a large part of the video, but anyway, let's get straight into it. Coming in at number 5, we have Ty Dillon and Brett Moffitt getting into each other late in the Xfinity race. They were 3 wide with Josh Berry coming off turn 2, and I guess Ty Dillon just thought that he was cleared or didn't know Brett was up there. I'm not really sure what happened, but regardless, Ty Dillon ended up getting into Moffitt, and he was turned into the outside wall. Moffitt appeared to get off relatively easy, but he actually had a tire go down and rode turn 3 and 4 wall. And then there was a second part of the crash while trying to avoid the incident. Alex LeBay smashed into the back of Garrett Smithley. I didn't see a replay of this. I don't think there was a camera angle of it, but it was a pretty nasty hit apparently, because it set Alex LeBay's car into flames. Like I said, unfortunately, there wasn't a camera angle of this because that was probably the worst part of the crash. But anyways, let's take a look at number 4. At number 4, we have Tyler Ankrum's hard hit in the inside wall late in the race with 12 ups to go. It was just complete chaos in the midfield. A couple of the Camping World trucks got together. Josh Anderson slammed into Ankrum, and Ankrum was just on for the ride. He was just a victim inside of 4 wide. Couldn't see it coming, and before he even knew it, he was headed straight to the inside wall. Unfortunately, Anderson was caught up and hit the inside wall as well, ending both their days. Unfortunately for Ankrum, this is just the story of his year so far. His finishes this year are 28th, 21st, and 34th. It just has not been the start to the season that he would have liked. Coming in at number 3 is the big one from Friday night's truck race. It started off with Rafael Lessard cutting down in front of David Gilliland. It was simply a mistake on Lessard's part. He actually tweeted out an apology where he directly apologized to David Gilliland and all the other drivers involved. So that was very mature of him to admit to a mistake that he made. Rest of the trucks came piling in. They didn't have really anywhere to go. If you were in the outside lane, then you were pretty much a victim, such as like Haley Deegan and Ryan Truex just had nowhere to go. For Lessard, pretty much the same story as with Ankrum. This is the last thing he needed, with a very slow start to the season as well, with finishes of 23rd, 26th, and 30th. Coming in at number 2, we have Corey Roper's big hit. And I know there's going to be a lot of people that disagree with me because the big one had a lot of cars, and yes, I get that, but Roper's impact was massive. Roper was turned at nearly the fastest part of the track, which the impact isn't as bad as it would have been with the driver's side door, just because safety has improved and safer barriers, but still, it was a wild hit. It definitely had me holding my breath. It all started when Tyler Hill, Timmy Hill's brother, was turned into Corey, and it just shot him straight up the track into the driver's side wall. With that being said, let's get into this week's top crash. And finally, the number 1 crash of the week was Connor Daly's massive hit and fire early on in the Truck Series race. Heading into turns 1 and 2, he was in the middle of 3 wide and just lost it. As they said on the broadcast, you know, this could have just been simply misjudging the air, and where he doesn't have enough experience in these trucks, it could be due to that. Just keep in mind that this is just his second start, and he's used to racing Indy cars as opposed to NASCAR trucks. And once again, I know that's going to be very controversial between this crash and Roper's crash, But I think the fire from Dally's incident just really adds to it a lot more and goes to show that it was actually a harder hit. And there will be even more controversy that both these crashes are ahead of the big one. But that's all part of the fun of this series, that we all get to have our opinions, and you just see a little bit of my perspective of these crashes and how I view them. But anyways, guys, I want to thank you for sticking to the end of the second episode of the Top 5 NASCAR Crashes of the Week, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.